much for being here. And by the way, thank you for volunteering, because you've been a volunteer for 32 years. It's incredible. Mm-hmm. And this does not happen without the volunteers. And especially the biggest part of all of this is all about scholarships.
It's large. We love what we do out there, though. Everybody contributes. There's 33,000 volunteers that put into getting these life-changing scholarships.
That is staggering. Well, and you have a day job, so you arrange your schedule. You're a flight attendant for Delta Airlines, but you take a full month off so that you can be there for rodeo to volunteer. Why have you done this for so long? What is it about the rodeo that keeps you coming back every year?
You know, my friends are out there now, but it fills my heart. Every day out there, I find joy. I truly do. We're giving back to the community. We're changing lives. We're teaching people discipline, the kids that are out there showing horses. There's so much out there.
And they've all become your family. Come on now.
Right? Yes. And Echo, I'm so glad you jumped in, because you're a recipient from the scholarship from 1998.
20 years ago.
I mean, how did that affect you at that time to be able to have that money?
I mean, it was huge. I was small town from a farming, ranching community. I'd been in 4-H for a long time in my life, and I applied. It sent me to college, and I got out with no college debt, which
that's huge.
Not many people are able to do.
Right, or say.
And you were accepted to West Point, the Air Force Academy, Auburn University, but you decided, good choice, Texas A&M.
Texas A&M.
Graduated after just 3 years.
I did.
But you sort of, changed your path along the way. You decided maybe med school was not the path for you. So and what happened instead?
I ended up working for a small company that got purchased and acquired by Warner Brothers, and I've spent the last 10 years at Warner Brothers.
Working in Hollywood, folks.
Right. Yeah. Small kid, right? Not what most probably would assume of a scholarship recipient from the Houston Livestock Show.
And that's what's interesting, too, to trace the roots back. I mean, working in Hollywood, working for one of the most well-known companies in the world, tracing the roots back to rodeo, I mean, safe to say that the scholarship you received from the Houston Livestock Show and rodeo, that affected your life in a big way.
Absolutely, it affected my life in a big way. And now here I am, and I'm back in Houston, able to be part of the rodeo, because I wasn't growing up when I received the scholarship even. And you never know what is going to come in your path, what the Lord's going to provide.
Absolutely. I think that is so great. And Tricia, walk us through the process, because I know there's parents out there. I've got young boys. I'm like, how does this work? How can we get in on this? You know, how do you do it?
There's an online application that everybody must fill out. It opens in November, and it is due by the beginning of February, and then all the supplemental documents that support that have to be in the rodeo at the rodeo office by February 14th this year. And anybody can apply. That is something that a lot of people don't know. Everybody thinks that you have to have a horse or a cow to apply, but you do not. Everybody in Houston that is a graduating senior can apply for a Houston Livestock Show and Rodeo scholarship.
And I understand that it's not just about grades. When taking into account someone's accomplishments, a young person's accomplishment, you want to know their volunteer hours, a lot of extracurricular activities that are also taken into consideration. Is that right?
We do take that into consideration. We take their activities, but we also have started taking their job experience, because some of these kids that need scholarships need to work for their families. So if they don't have that many activities, but they're working full-time jobs or part-time jobs, we have to take that into consideration as well.
I think it's so awesome. How great is this for you, Echo, to be back here and being part of all of this? This is so awesome.
And it's really exciting. I now have a little one that's 2, and so her favorite thing is rodeo, especially to go see all of the animals and the babies that are in the nursery that are there. And the opportunity to be in Houston and be able to give back to what was given so much to me, and now looking for what's next for my career in Houston.
So
fantastic.
Awesome.
And has it also inspired you to give back as well?
Oh, absolutely. When you're not in Houston, you don't understand rodeo.
Right.
Because rodeo, we were talking about it. It's not just a place that you go to see everything. It's the culture. It's the life. It's the family. It's all of the things that you want to see in something. Houston comes together. It is just amazing. It's so much fun.
Absolutely. And you got to get out there. I know, like, everybody wants to go to the concerts and the carnival, but the bottom line is all of those fun things is the whole sole reason for those scholarships. That's how it's all funded, basically, and all the fun parties leading up to it.
It's so much fun. But you know, one thing that I was talking to one of my friends is that everybody in Houston contributes. If you buy a hot dog out there, you contribute as much as you if you buy a steer out there. So everybody contributes.
I'm definitely buying hot dogs.
I mean, a steer could come in handy too.
I know. I don't roll in those crowds, man. I don't roll in that crowd.
Trisha and Echo, thanks to you both for your time today. Trisha, thank you for your 32 years of volunteerism.
Absolutely.
Congrats on your family and your career, and continued success to you as well. As always, if you would like more information on all things rodeo, you can just visit the Scene on Houston Life section of our website.